Hi, in this video, we're going to talk about k-nearest neighbors algorithm in Python programming language, so please stay tuned. So now let's start with the concept of KNN. By saying KNN, I mean k-nearest neighbors. So for example, suppose this point, this black point, and suppose that we want to determine the class, or let's say the label of that point, of that black point. In order to do so with the KNN algorithm, we are going to look at the k nearest neighbors. For example, if you choose k equal to 3, it means that you are going to look at the 3 nearest neighbors of that black point. And for example, in this slide, as you can see, the 3 nearest neighbors, 2 of them are red and 1 of them is blue. So you can see the majority vote is red. So because the majority of its k nearest neighbors are red, we are going to assign the red class or the red label to that black point. But suppose that we consider k equal to 5. In that case, we are going to consider the 5 nearest neighbors of that black point. And as you can see, 3 of that 5 neighbors are blue and 2 of them are red. So here the majority vote is blue. So we are going to assign the blue label to that black point. So the general idea of k-nearest neighbors algorithm is this. We are going to look at the k-nearest neighbors of a point, and we are going to consider the majority vote. And based on the majority vote, we are going to assign a label to each point. So this is how we are going to predict the class, or let's say the label of any point in the KNN algorithm. So now let's do it in Python. So first of all, we should import the proper packages. So we simply type from sklearn.neighbors import kNeighbors classifier. And then we are going to use kNeighbors classifier, and we are going to determine number of neighbors, for example, equal to 7. And we are going to create an object, let's say called model. So now we are defining our model, we are building our model. And then we simply fit our model on X train and Y train. And after building the model, we are going to predict and evaluate for the model in order to see how much well our model is going to work. So simply we type model.predict, we are going to predict for x test, and then we are going to store the predicted values in a variable, let's say called yPred, I mean the predictions for our y. Then we want to evaluate. The simplest metric in order to evaluate our classification model is accuracy. So we simply type from sklearn.metrics import accuracy score, and then we are using accuracy score, and this should pass y true, which is y test, which is the y test of our data, and then the predicted values, which is y pred. And now we are going to store the results in a variable, let's say called acc, and here we are going to print the results. So the accuracy is equal to acc, and if I run the code, you can see the accuracy is 92%. But now let's suppose that I choose another value for number of neighbors. For example, suppose that I choose 50 for number of neighbors. So if I run the code, you can see the accuracy is 84%, which is not very good. So here's a question. What is the proper value for that number of neighbors in KNN? Well, it's a good question, but we are not going to talk about this question in this video. We are going to address this question in future videos. But there are problems with this accuracy score in some cases, which we are going to talk about in future video, and we are going to talk about confusion matrix in future video.